6 turnovers for the Lady Eagles, 10 for Arkansas State. Winner Rogers, 3 on the way, off the mark. Dom Davis. And a melee going on the bench over at Southern Miss.
This could get ugly. It has gotten ugly.
This could be really bad as Davis was tied up with Emma Emevbere. Emevbere, a shoved her, and punches were thrown as well. Southern Miss assistant coach Jessica Barber involved in some action. She was on the court as well.
We saw Dominique Davis and Emevbere got tied up. Got tied up there initially, and then just a melee. I hate to call it anything else, but you see just a lot of people getting involved. Kind of hard not to be involved. And now I think we actually have some other people on the floor as well, but trying to get everything resolved over there by the Southern Miss bench.
Yeah, I think a fan maybe even came down. Jessica Barber, assistant coach, is still being attended to on the Southern Miss bench. Berkayla Gray actually left the court with Southern Miss athletic personnel. Davis being tended to by Matt Gardner.
And our officials have their work cut out for them right now, Lee. They're going to have to watch several different angles, whatever we can give them from a camera's point of view. They're going to have to look at this because this could be bad for several players.
Yeah, and I think the biggest part of this right now is Jessica Barber. You can see she's in the brown, still on the ground as well, being attended to.
Well, we're looking at replays on a different screen, Lee, of what they're seeing, but you see her right there on the ground being what we saw in the replay was, as you mentioned, several different players kind of falling on top of her, and her shoe is off now. They're looking at her lower leg for possibly an injury to assistant coach Jessica Barber. Let's certainly hope she's okay. Officials are looking at the game, the game replays and films. But what we see in our little replay film over here on the other screen, they're going to have their work cut out for them to figure out what's going to be the cause for who's going to be ejected or who's going to get the fouls. We'll see.
They're sorting it out here in Hattiesburg. We'll take a break while they do that. Stay tuned for more from the greenhouse. As the officials under review, Gina Cantanzariti, Randy Robertson, and Natasha Brown taking a look at what just transpired here inside Reed Green Coliseum. It had been a physical game. Dom Davis had some altercations with a couple different players, and then along on the sideline right in front of the Lady Eagle bench, they got tied up once again as we take a look at what transpired between the Lady Eagles and the Red Wolves. Again, Dom Davis tied up with Mesbury, and you can see right there, Mesbury just throws Davis on the ground and starting to throw punches as, once again, Jessica Barber gets in underneath a big pile of Lady Eagles. There are ladies that had came out of the stands as well, and we believe they have been escorted out. Again, Berkayla Gray was on the court. She had walked off the court under supervision with the athletic training personnel for Southern Miss as well. Let's just hope that, one, Berkayla Gray is okay, Jessica Barber is okay, and that the officials get this one squared away. Larry, I'd rather be sitting where I am right now than those officials having to take action in this part right here.
Yeah, we're trying to describe what we saw, and I'm a bit in shock. You mentioned there were a couple of tie-ups, but there weren't any flagrant fouls or anything. Just a couple of times where the players had gotten tied up, and you saw a little bit of pulling and shoving or whatever, but nothing that would have escalated to this so quickly. There was not. I didn't see an elbow thrown. I just saw Dom Davis, number 2 for Southern Miss, and number 14, Emma Emevbere, get tied up again. And then when they separated, that's where the pushing and the shoving and the melee started over there by the bench. The good news for Arkansas State is none of their bench players participated. Obviously, it wasn't by their bench. Their coaches did a really good job of keeping their players at bay, keeping them down there. But it was literally on top of some of the other Southern Miss players. So it will be hard to decipher who is defending themselves from injury or who's participating in the brawl or the scuff up, let's call it, not a brawl, but the scuff up that we saw over there on the bench. So again, I'm like you, I would not want to be one of these three officials trying to decipher who stays and who goes.
And that's what makes this all so difficult is because it did take part right in front of the bench. It's not like any bench player came off the bench to participate. At some point you have to protect yourself and protect your teammates. Unfortunately, Emebere, the junior out of London, was the lone Red Wolf along the bench. And
saw a quick shot of Jessica Barber there, the assistant coach that we saw on the replay, how a lot of the bodies involved fell on her. It looked like her right leg may have gotten caught, tangled up in there. Good to see her, though she's not upstanding, good to see her sitting up straight. Looks a little flustered, and I can understand why. She got caught in the middle of something that she had no control over. And let's just hope she's okay. And let's hope Emebere is okay as well. Didn't see any punches land. Just saw a lot of pushing and shoving. Again, we'll get an explanation in a minute from these three officials right here. But sometimes when you see those early tussles in the game, you'll see a referee make a quick call, say, hey, we're not going to allow that tonight. But it wasn't any – two or three of the little tie-ups, it wasn't anything that warranted a call. I mean, it was just two guys going on after it. There was no shoving, no pushing, nothing premeditated what we just saw in my mind. Now, obviously, there could have been something else that went on that we didn't see or the cameras didn't see. But I thought that was a quick reaction there by the tie-up between Dom Davis and 14 Emebere.
Well, I tell you, it was a really good job by the officials because they were right involved as well, having to separate the players and then also other personnel from the University of Southern Mississippi that jumped in to help facilitate as well. So we're being told that it's a common foul on Dom Davis and that multiple ejections possibly. However, nothing is confirmed. Again, as Gina Contanzariti, the referee that is taking care of reviewing, also Randy Robertson, the umpire, and Natasha Brown, also the umpire. They are taking a good look. It's been a long look, Larry. I'm going to say this has probably gone on for a good 7 or 8 minutes at this point.
Well, Lee, nobody wins in this situation. It's literally on your bench. So if you're a player and you're sitting there and it's going on and you try to even if you're trying to separate the players, right, and you grab the opponent, you grab their player, you could be deemed as participating and being involved. But like you said, no one came out onto the court. It was one of those things that just literally they fell into the Southern Miss bench. And so now you've got one Arkansas State player over there and basically the entire bench over there involved in one way or another, either being a peacemaker or you know, who knows what. You couldn't really see deep down inside of the scrum, if you will. But again, these three refs, they're looking at it. They want to get it right. As you said, this has been an eight to ten minute break, and looks like we're going to take another break while they try to figure it out. Hopefully, when we come back, we'll have this all figured out. We'll get back to what we were watching was some really good basketball. So let's take a break. Southern Miss up 30-26.
We are still in official review. It's been going on for over 10 minutes now. Again, just a quick recap. Dom Davis had gotten tied up. And when I say tied up, Larry, you know, we saw it a couple times, just her arm gets tied up with Arkansas State Red Wolf. This time, she was tied up with Emebere right in front of the Lady Eagle bench. And I'm sure there had been words exchanged most of the evening already. And the unfortunate part is it has been a very, very good game. You can see Amevere give Davis a little bit of a shove, and then she shoved her big time and punches started throwing. Unfortunately, coaches involved underneath the action. Coach Jack Trosper holding back Dom Davis. Officials pulling players away. Brekayla Gray looked like she had been maybe hit in the head with some sort. She actually had left the game on her own to go to the locker room just to get things checked out. Again, a long review by the officials. Once again, it's Gina Catanzariti, Randy Robertson, and Natasha Brown taking a look here with the replay crew. On the scores table.
Lee, this is what makes it so difficult for these three guys right here. So it happens on the Southern Miss bench. For instance, I saw 35, Asia Leak, grabbing Emevere, trying to pull her off of the melee. So is that deemed being a peacemaker? Is that deemed an ejection?
Right.
Is that deemed participating, coming off the bench? I don't know. But that's all that I saw Asia Leak do. And it will be interesting to see, does she get ejected? She grabbed Emevere up around the shoulder area, head and shoulder area, to try to pull her off of the Southern Miss player that she was on. And again, is that deemed participating in a fight? And if it is, then she would be ejected. But it just, you're just in a no-win situation. You sit there and don't help your teammates out, you don't look like a very good teammate, to be honest. But obviously, any participation in a fight or in a scuffle like we've seen could deem ejection for Southern Miss. Will not be surprised if we have multiple ejections in this basketball game.
Again, the officials are doing their due diligence by making sure that they look at this from every camera angle. Again, Lee Phil, our producer, and his crew do a tremendous job each game with multiple cameras and camera angles. The officials are making sure that they are looking at each one. And again, the unfortunate thing, you just like to say, if this did not happen in front of a bench, would it have been as big of a melee per se? However, because it was in front of the Lady Eagle bench, a lot more participated than probably would have. Good to see that Brekayla Gray is back out with her team as well, as she had walked off the court with the athletic training personnel for the Lady Eagles. And again, we're being told a common foul and potentially some ejections as well. Nothing confirmed. When they confirm and finish the review, we will relay that information to you. But regardless, the unfortunate thing is that, you know, teams will not benefit from this. I mean, obviously a hard fought quarter and almost two quarters of play. Really, it was a really good two quarters of play as well before that scuffle or fight, if you will. And now Jessica Barber is being helped off the court with.
I believe we even had a couple of fans that were escorted out of the Coliseum as well. I'm not going to speculate on who that was being escorted out, I can only imagine. But we're literally watching assistant coach Jessica Barber right now being escorted off the court. There you see her. And I did see, I mentioned Asia Leak was trying to break up the fight, and she grabbed Emevere, tried to pull her off, and when she did, she lost her balance, and she's the one who actually fell on Jessica Barber. So again, it's an unfortunate thing that has happened. As you mentioned, it happened right in, not only in front of the bench, but on to the, started in front and ended up in the Southern Miss bench. I don't know, as an official, as we keep showing the officials, how you decide who was involved and who wasn't when you had such a big body of people involved, coaches, assistant coaches, players, starters, some on the floor, some on the bench. This is why it's taken so long to decide and make this ruling. They'll come over here in a minute and explain to us exactly what is happening.
Again, once again, a great job by the administration from the University of Southern Mississippi jumping in to separate the player from the team. And also by the officials to break it up as quickly as they could. Because it really could have gotten more out of hand if Red Wolf players had come down across midcourt. But again, unfortunately, it was Emma Mevere who was right in front of the Lady Eagle bench.
Well, and it's easy sitting where we are to say, hey, this is what y'all do. But they could have easily sent both teams up into the locker rooms, make that 10, 12-minute time, their halftime, come back out, finish the last 2 minutes and 32 seconds of this one, and then just have a regular break between quarters and start the third quarter. But as you said, we've had a 10 or 15-minute break. These girls probably need to warm up now. This is a longer break than you have during halftime. So would not have been surprised to see them, let us sort this out. Y'all go have your halftime right now. But they did not do that. So we'll finish this last 2 minutes and 32 seconds with whoever's left to play, and then we'll have a halftime, and then we'll have the third quarter and the fourth quarter. And then we got another ball game after that, Lee.
Yeah, no need to rest tonight, right? Lots of action here inside the greenhouse. The unfortunate thing, again, that it was a really good basketball game. 30 points for the Lady Eagles and 26 for the Red Wolves. Just a four-point game. And this game means so much to both teams. Both teams' record 13-10. They're both 6-6 in the conference. They're tied for seventh place in the Sun Belt Conference. And the Lady Eagles will host Texas State on Saturday. The Red Wolves will travel to Louisiana. The Red Wolves will then head back to Jonesboro, Arkansas for a four-game homestand. The Lady Eagles will be on the road for their four games following this homestand here.
That homestand and that road swing for Southern Miss includes a rematch between these two next Saturday night at Arkansas State. I would imagine that game is going to be called very, very closely after what has happened and transpired here this evening. We're being told right now in our ears who the personal fouls and the ejection. So, Lee, you get all the information.
Yeah,
share
so
that
Dom
us.
Davis has been charged with a personal foul. And for the Lady Eagles, it is confirmed Raquela Gray, Dom Davis, Lonnie Cornfield, and Asia Leak have all been disqualified from this evening's game. And for the Red Wolves, number 14, Emma Amevere, has been disqualified as well. So one player, the only player that was involved for Arkansas State, has been disqualified. Four different players for the Lady Eagles, which will really deplete this Lady Eagle bench. We're going to get to see some action from some players, possibly, that really haven't had a whole lot of action. Raquela Gray's one that has had 17 starts on the year. She didn't start this evening. However, Dom Davis and Lonnie Cornfield did. Those three ejected, as I said. Asia Leak, who gets a lot of playing time, she comes in place of Malia Grayson as well. She has been disqualified. Nobody has left the respective benches yet. However, as you see, the players once again ejected for the respective teams as the officials talking with both Destiny Rogers for Arkansas State and Joy Lee McNellis for the Lady Eagles. Just, Larry, has to be a very tough call.
Yeah,
has to be a really tough call for these officials.
Like I said, I don't know how you deem who was involved in a scuffle and then who was just there involved in being in that part of the Coliseum at the moment, because they literally fell into the Southern Miss bench. And so if I'm sitting there and someone falls into my lap and I'm grabbing, trying to, whatever, am I deemed participating in it? I don't know how. That's very, very, first of all, it's a very misfortunate thing for college basketball and for women's basketball for this to happen at all. Secondly, it's even more unfortunate that this happened, and because it happened so close to the Southern Miss bench and they fell into the bench, more players were involved than would normally have done. Here we're going to take one more look. There's a tie-up between Dom, a little bit of a shove, now a big shove. Dom Davis gets down. There you see a swing. Again, now what do you see? I mean, it's just nothing but bodies everywhere.
smart play by the three Arkansas State players. He's walking back towards the camera angle. Didn't see that till right then. They've been coached well to walk away. It would have been so easy, Lee, for them to go help their teammates. But if they do, they're immediately ejected from the game. So puts them in a tough situation because obviously they want to help their teammate, but they walked away knowing that they had to. Well, for Southern Miss, some of their players had no choice. They were involved the moment it fell into their lap, so to speak. So that's why you see four Southern Miss players ejected and only one for Arkansas State. So heads up play by Arkansas State there, walking away, which is sometimes, Lee, the hardest thing to do. You got to tip your hat to those three ladies who walked away. And, you know, that doesn't make them any less of a teammate than those that were helping their teammates out. I mean, it's just so unfortunate. A great basketball game we had at 30-26 with both teams playing well has been delayed now for 20 minutes or so, and we've got five players now who will not participate for the rest of this game.
Yeah, the delay is actually now 23 minutes long. And, Larry, this is going to be a pivotal part. You know, I'm going to go ahead and say there are also three fans that were ejected as well. So three fans that came onto the floor. But again, I'm going to give credit to Destiny Rogers, her coaching staff, for reacting the way they did. They came over to try to separate their players. And what they did was they were able to get their four players that were also on the floor away, as you mentioned. And now we're going to see Izzy Higginbottom attempting free throws. So this is a pivotal part of this game. 2:32 to play, a four-point lead for the Lady Eagles, and Arkansas State's going to have six free throws, and they will also get the basketball following these foul shots from Izzy Higginbottom.
Well, and again, I know the fans are upset that are in here because it seems like Southern Miss got the worst end of this deal, and they did. But it did fall into the Arkansas State bench. It fell into the Southern Miss bench. And now, looking over there, it looks like there are three players that are dressed out that are not from Southern Miss, possibly down to eight players playing in this basketball game tonight.
Well, Higginbottom missed the first free throw and then hit five in a row. So because of that melee, because of that 23-minute delay, because of the four ejections, the common foul had put Izzy Higginbottom on the line. Arkansas State, in a pivotal part of this game this evening, they now took their first lead of the game. And Larry, we can talk all we want about Izzy Higginbottom's two fingers, but she just took six foul shots right there, made five of them. It didn't look like her fingers affected her whatsoever. I got to imagine that she's going to be the player for Arkansas State that will step up here. Wilkerson gives it over to Rogers. Rogers hits the three, an eight-point swing following the melee. A four-point lead now for Arkansas State.